G'day guys, back again, and we've got another blast from the past in regards to Tamir figures, this time around the German Panzer Grenadiers 135 scale. Now guys, as I said in one of my other Tamir videos, or maybe a couple of them for the figures, this was another set that I just thought was absolutely awesome when it came out. This set came out, I think maybe, it's got copyright on the box of 1985, so we'll go with 1985. And again, Tamir, the box art, I mean, absolutely beautiful box art. And the thing with Tamir is the positions of these guys, or the poses of these guys, is absolutely fantastic. If an up-to-date resin company today, like Alpine Miniatures, Evolution Miniatures, there's a couple of new ones coming out as well, started doing these figures and these poses, a whole set like this, because I know Evolution Miniatures, they do big sets. This would be an absolute cracker of a set for Evolution Miniatures to do. Quick look at the sides of the box. And I look at the back of the box with the figure poses, and again, eight figures, absolute bargain. Some of these sets you can pick up for almost around $8 Australian, absolute bargain, if you ask me, for eight figures. And these poses, I know I've said it, but absolutely fantastic poses. I'll zoom in on this tank for you guys, the Panzer. I used to love the Tamir catalogs, because I used to do some little dioramas in them. They don't do it as much as they used to now. The older Tamir catalogs, they used to do one or two reasonably big dioramas in their catalogs, or maybe one or two pages, almost a centerfold, guys, of military modeling. It was just something that you could really get excited about. And just the other picture here now, I mean, look at this here, guys. I mean, this is just a diorama in itself, isn't it? I mean, look at number one here. This guy, he's like looking around the corner going, shh, I think there's someone coming, guys. We better keep an eye out. Look at this guy. The kneeling guy, he's like, oh, geez, he's just jumped over a wall or something. He's like, oh, I think I've hurt my ankle. I don't think I can get back up again. The guy on the ground, he's like, do I really have to keep crawling this far? This is going to take me a long time to get over there. But classic pose. The other guy there, he's the other guy going, shh, are you sure there's someone coming around the corner? Really? Is there? And number one's going, yeah, just wait, he's coming. And you've got number five down the bottom here, and he's a bit like going, this is a really uncomfortable pose. My knee's really hurting me. I'm going to get up in a second. And the other guy, number six, he's like, oh, I'm just going to hang on to this wall here. And he's peeking over the top of the wall, and he's like, oh, is that a Sherman? Is that a Sherman coming? Sounds like a Sherman. And this other guy, number seven, he's sitting on the wall. He's got a great pose. He's like, I'm sitting on top of this tank, and I ain't getting off. I'm not walking for no one. Absolute beautiful pose as well. And this guy, number eight, now he's got an interesting pose. For a rifle guy, he's sort of, you know, leaning on top of the tank over the turret. He's like, if you keep turning the turret, I'm not going to hit anything at the rate I'm going. I mean, seriously, look at these poses of these guys. Absolutely fantastic. Look, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I'm not going to muck around. I love this pose. I love this pose. I like this pose. This pose, not too bad. This pose isn't too bad. That pose, not too bad. I actually really like this pose. Actually, I do really like this pose as well. This guy here, he's pretty awkward. I could do without him. He's a little bit strange. He might get away with him on the tank like that. It looks like he's Mr. Spaghetti Legs there. Let's take a quick look inside, guys. Now, as I said in my other video, guys, I'm not going to sit here and rave about how fantastic these figures are now, as in the sculpting and the casting. But what I will say is back then, these were a great set of figures to pick up. Oh, guys, an added bonus. Absolutely fantastic. Don't you love it when Tamir just throws these little things in? I can't remember seeing this little picture before. But again, isn't this? It's just a little diorama all in one. Apart from the groundwork, of course, and the trees and the buildings. Maybe a bridge, maybe some water, maybe some telephone poles. Apart from all of that, guys, it's pretty much a diorama all in one. Look at this. Now, this to me, guys, is why people love Tamir kits. I mean, they just go that little bit of extra mile. This one actually probably more than a lot of other ones with the little pictures. Absolutely fantastic. But look at all these little positions these guys are in. I mean, I'm liking them even more now. Look at this guy here on the bricks. And this guy here, the old shh, someone's coming. And this guy, he's like, shh, are you sure? Are you sure? But then this guy here, he's okay. He's all right. This guy here's pretty good, actually, with the fuel drums there. That looks a bit better. And look at on the sandbags. That makes more sense, sitting on the sandbags like that. That'd be a bit more comfortable. This guy here, what an absolute cracker of a little page from Tamir. Love it. Kits, I don't know if they've just released this. If you've got some of the really, really old versions of this kit that you've had for, like, whatever, since 1985... I can never remember them coming with all these decals back then. But maybe they did, maybe they didn't. But geez, they look pretty good. You know, sometimes Tamir decals are a bit on the thickish side. sometimes. The newer ones are a lot better. I don't know what these are going to be like, guys. I don't like telling people what decals are going to be like until I actually put them on a kit and use them myself. You know, I'm not a professional decal whisperer. I can't tell you what's going on here, guys. I can only just show you what I'm seeing myself. But it's better than nothing. I'm just going to zoom around quickly on these sprues, the two sprues, and show you some of the parts. I'm not going to show you all of them. And to be honest with you guys, probably looking at this set, I think it's probably a bit cruder than the other set that I showed you probably a couple of days ago. I've just linked the molding probably isn't as good as that. And I'm not saying that it's fantastic in the other one either. But I'm just saying that I just love these Tamiya older kits, and I have good memories about them. So that's why I'm just doing some short videos on them. If you're not a big fan of them, you know, move on to one of my other videos. As I was saying, some of my other videos, some of the heads on some of these older Tamiya figures were really not that pretty. They're pretty, I call them sort of potato heads, because they were sort of a little bit mashed up to me, a bit fat sometimes on the face, a bit flat. And also, if you can see there, the uniforms, you know, I mean, we're talking 1985, guys, but, you know, maybe they were actually sculpted earlier than this, given that, you know, that's when it was done. Could have been, the figures could have been done even a couple of years before that, but just, you know, nowhere up to today's standard. But as I always say, if you're just starting out in figure painting, start on some of these guys. You know, they're cheap, you know, $8, $9 or $10 Australian or $7.99 or whatever Australian, guys, for a bargain. It's an absolute bargain. You know, you're getting what you pay, especially getting what you pay for now, and you are definitely getting what you pay for. I still think it's good value for like $8 for eight figures. I mean, that's a dollar a figure, and that's including that you're getting decals that you could probably use on other kits if you wanted to. And on top of that, you're still getting the weapons and stuff. And although the weapons may not be fantastic, you know, you could still whack them in a diorama, guys. You know, not right in full front view, but, you know, if you want to put them in the back or in a truck or something like that, or on the, you know, you could place them somewhere. Again, they're pretty hard shapes, these guys, and there's not much detail on them. And on some of them, the buckles are pretty non-existent on the pieces. And the hands, you know, I mean, some of the hands aren't too bad. I mean, if you really were desperate for a certain hand shape and you couldn't find it on your resin figure or something like that, but you nearly wanted one. I know Hornet does some hands and a couple other people do some hand sets, but they're pretty expensive. But if you just wanted a certain hand shape that you needed for, you know, maybe even, you know, a cheap figure or something, just a hand that you wanted to be holding something like some of the wine bottles that I showed you, some of these probably wouldn't be too bad because there's a lot of them open up for the rifles. You could probably cut one of these hands off and use it, you know, to be holding a wine bottle or something like that, or whatever, a beer bottle or whatever you like. Look, I've got to say, these rifles, you know, for the price, as I said, a dollar a figure, you can't really complain about these rifles for a dollar a figure, guys. Again, the equipment, you know, it's dated now, guys. It's dated. It's pretty crude, you know. I'm not going to tell you stories. A couple more faces there. It's a fair bit of flash on the heads there, coming around to where the ears are. Almost looks like he's wearing a visor with that amount of flash on his head. You see the lovely seam lines running down the figure that you want to clean up. Or you don't have to, as I said in one of my other videos, my tutorial. I'd advise you to clean them up. It just looks a lot better, guys. It doesn't take that long to clean them up. It'll make your figure look a lot better. A little bit more on the equipment there. A couple more hands. Beautiful box arts. Absolutely love them. Hope you enjoyed this one, guys. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.